So I'm Gregory Bryant, and I lead the Client Computing Group at Intel, which means I'm responsible for all the technology and chips that go into client devices. I kind of run the full gamut. And at CES this year, we made kind of several very key announcements. We showed and announced that we're launching 6 new 9th generation Core desktop processors that we're really excited about. And then in addition to that, we announced and demonstrated some new 10 nanometer products on stage. One is codenamed Ice Lake, which is our first volume client 10 nanometer product. I also showed a product called Lakefield, which is very unique in that it uses some new 3D packaging technology and a whole new architecture to do very small chip and very small boards. And then we also announced a new innovation program that we're working with a whole PC ecosystem called Project Athena, and showed very broad support for that. And then last but not least, we talked about bringing 10 gigabit bandwidth to the home in a partnership in the Americas, in North America, that we're doing with Comcast. But also it was more than just that, it was really about also bringing Wi-Fi and increasing speeds for Wi-Fi inside the home with support for Wi-Fi 6. Which gives you kind of 2 gigabits per second Wi-Fi inside the home that we'll be doing all around the world. So the 9th generation Core desktops we're shipping this month now. I did say that we're gonna bring 9th generation Core to notebooks next quarter, so that's Q2. Ice Lake will have systems on shelf by the end of this year for holiday season, so we're excited about that. Lakefield, I didn't mention it in the keynote, but will be in production ourselves for silicon by the end of 2019, by the end of this year, and then you'd see systems from, you know, our customers after that, shortly after that. In terms of what you can expect from 10 nanometer products, you know, anytime you make the transistor smaller and you drive density, you know, you're gonna see obviously higher performance devices, as well as typically we drive greater power efficiency. So, you know, what we're really excited about with these new 10 nanometer products is that we can get into innovative, sleeker new form factors and designs. I want to say Ice Lake in particular that we demonstrated is probably the most integrated SoC we've ever done. And I think sometimes that gets lost when people talk about nanometers and process technology. It's a new CPU core, yes, but it has brand new graphics core, integrated Thunderbolt, integrated Wi-Fi, integrated instructions for machine learning. It's pretty incredible, and that's all enabled because we can drive, you know, the density and the new transistors required to do that. To me, that is a very key trend, maybe the key trend for us and our customers, is you have to go beyond just the CPU, just beyond one benchmark. It's really about, it's an optimization problem. Of course, we love technology, we're engineers at our hearts, so we like optimizing things, solving problems. So that being able to deliver new capabilities and features, as you just said, Thunderbolt, Wi-Fi, graphics, CPU, but optimizing it at a platform level so the user gets the best experience, that's very difficult. But it's something that we're committed to doing and we're excited to do. And at the end of the day, I think end users are gonna see some really, really tangible benefits. And obviously, there's a lot of anticipation and excitement for us to deliver discrete graphics for the client and in the data center. I mean, we said we'd have our first discrete graphics done by the end of 2020, and we're hard at work doing that. In the meantime, I would say a great measure of progress, is the Gen 11 integrated graphics. That core, that IP that is our graphics engine, our core IP, that we're delivering in Ice Lake is a huge step forward from where we were today. You know, think, you know, from 50% to 100% faster performance in that IP. That's what we're gonna deliver with Ice Lake. And then as we go to our next generation, Gen 12 graphics IP, we're gonna get that same kind of jump again. And that IP, that Gen 12 graphics IP, will be the foundation for our discrete graphics. So it's important to say, yeah, discrete graphics is an important endpoint, everybody's really excited, but there's also these major milestones along the way in improving our IP. And it's important for us to deliver on those, and we are.